Hello everyone, my name is Vipra Joshi and I am an assistant professor in St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management in Electrical Engineering Department. Today I am going to deliver a lecture on subject of basic electrical engineering. In this video, I will be explaining moving iron type instruments. This is unit 4th topic of second semester in first year engineering. Moving iron type instrument. Moving iron type instrument is used for measure the current and voltage to an accuracy. Ammeter and voltmeter are the example of moving iron type instrument. These instruments are two types. First is attraction type and second is repulsion type. In the attraction type of instrument, when current is flowing through the coil, a magnetic field is produced in it, and moving iron moves because in moving iron there is some force at it, so the moving iron moves from weaker field to stronger field and the moving iron is attracted. This is the diagram of moving iron type instrument. The main part of any instrument is pointer or scale. This is a pointer. This is a pointer and this is a scale. So, this pointer is going to indicate on a scale. Here the pointer has to deflect. Pointer is deflected from zero position to maximum position. And to deflect a pointer, we need some mechanism. There will be an iron piece. We need to connect this iron piece to this pointer. This is an iron piece. So this iron piece is connected to the pointer through some mechanism. It's called a spindle. This is called a spindle. We are using magnetic field, so moves the pointer. Let us say we connect a DC supply to the coil. If we say here, if we have any supply, DC supply, and this is a coil, and we have a iron piece here. So if we connect here DC supply, then we can say that here two poles are produced, S and N. And in the moving, on this iron, here opposite poles are produced. It means N and S. If we draw this figure like this, this is S pole and this is N pole when we are giving a supply, and this is North pole and this is South pole. So this iron piece attracted to it because of magnetic field. Let us say we connect a DC supply in the coil and this will be now become an electromagnet. This will be now become an electromagnet. What happened? Whenever you put this iron piece into the magnetic field, it will be attracted. Whatever it may be, north pole or south pole. Imagine we have here S pole, south pole and north pole. So in the iron piece, the pole are produced is opposite polarity, north pole and south pole. If we have here produced pole is north pole and south pole, then in iron piece produced their opposite polarity pole, it is south pole and this is north pole. So whenever you put this iron piece into a magnetic field, an EMF is induced in it, and according to the Lenz's law, it is going to approach its causes. So instead of pulling it, it will be attracted. This iron piece is connected to the spindle. If we have AC supply during positive half cycle, if we give, because the moving iron type instrument work on both AC and DC supply. So if we have AC supply, this is AC, so during positive half cycle we can say that here upper plate is positive and lower plate will negative. So opposite polarity pole are produced here. And it is attracted, and during negative half cycle the pole are produced are N and S, and here opposite polarity are S and N. So spindle is connected to the spring for giving controlling torque. This spring is used for the controlling torque. Here we have three type of torque. First is deflection torque. Deflection torque is the torque which makes a pointer to move from zero position to maximum position. By deflection torque, the pointer moves from zero position to maximum position with her desired reading. And second is controlling torque. Controlling torque is responsible to compensate the extra deflection made by the pointer due to the deflection torque. If there is deflection torque, then the extra deflection is compensated by the controlling torque. And here we use the air damping, because damping torque is necessary to bring the moving system to come rest. This torque makes the pointer to return the pointer to the zero position gradually. After it, the reading has been made. So this is the working of attraction type of instrument, in which working mechanism based on the Fleming's left hand rule and electromagnetic force of attraction, and the moving coil is attracted to the coil, and by this the moving iron is attached to the spindle. So if moving iron moves, spindle also move, and by this the pointer is also moved, and this gives the reading on the scale. In repulsion type we have here two coils. First is fixed and second is movable coil. This is the diagram for repulsion type instrument. Let's take a figure. If we have any coil here and we have two iron pieces, one is fixed and other is movable, then if we give supply to this circuit, here the pole are produced are south pole and north pole, whatever poles are produced. Okay, then in two iron piece have opposite polarity pole are produced. So here these pole are N and S, and here also produced is pole polarity are N and S. So same polarity are produced in these iron piece, but these polarity are opposite to this magnet, this coil. After it is attracted towards the coil. Both poles are attracted towards the coil, but we know that these iron pieces are one is fixed and second is movable. So because of same polarity produced to in it, there is a force act on it. This is repulsion type of force. So these are reflect to each other. By this, moving coil are moved. Iron pieces are moved, and we can say that here in the moving iron piece we have a spindle. So if moving iron piece is moved, here the spindle is also moved and pointer attached to it is also moved on the scale. So if we see the working for the repulsion type of instrument, we can say that if we put two iron piece in the magnetic field, iron piece magnetize similarly because similar pole are produced in it. Thereby these two iron piece are repelled to each other. One iron piece has fixed and another iron piece are moving. Whenever it moves by the repulsion, the spindle moves and the pointer gives deflection on the scale. This is the working of repulsion type of instrument. Here we also have a controlling torque and deflecting damping torque. And the operating magnetic field in moving iron instrument is very weak, and therefore eddy current damping is not used because the field produced by the eddy current damping, it reduces to the magnetic field, and we can say it distorted to the operating magnetic field. So here we do not use the eddy current damping. That's why we use here air friction damping. Some advantage of moving iron instrument is it can be used both direct current and alternating current. It is simple in construction and the cost is very low. Here no contact leading the system are required for moving system, and it does not carry any active current through it. And next is high operating torque is produces in it, and the instrument is accurate for its design frequency range, which makes is useful for the measurement. It can withstand to the overcurrent for short period, which is quite common in AC circuits. And friction air are negligible, due to the high torque of weight ratio. As the moving parts are lightweight and all having part of the instrument are stationary part. So these are the advantages for moving iron type instrument. Now we discuss about permanent magnet moving coil. Permanent magnet moving coil is the basic measuring instrument which can be used for measuring current and voltage. But here we use permanent magnet for producing the magnetic field. They can be converted into either voltmeter or ammeter. These are the part for permanent magnet. Here the part are permanent magnet, rectangular coil, controlling spring, aluminium cylindrical core. This is the core and permanent magnet, and over it we have two soft steel ring for protection, and here we have a scale and dust proof case. Now we will discuss on the working of permanent magnet moving coil. Now if we see the figure of permanent moving coil, we can see that here this is a pointer and which is pointing out the different value on the scale so that we can read it. This is a spindle. And spindle is supported by the two rings, upper control spring and lower control spring. Also one coil is attached to the spindle. Here we have coil inside the spindle. Okay, so this coil carrying a current with the help of current, and if we supply any current in this coil, the coil carrying a current and by with the help of this current, a force is produced to the coil, and we can say a force is exerted on the coil and pointer is deflected certainly, and a force will be created by permanent magnet moving coil also, because here we use permanent magnet. So from the permanent magnet, a permanent magnetic field is produced, and one field is from permanent magnet and other field is produced in the moving coil. So by both force and deflection is created here, and the pointer is moved to in it. If we see the working for the permanent magnet moving coil, we can say that here when current flow in the coil on the aluminium former, a magnetic field is produced in the coil, and this magnetic field is proportional to the current. Okay, then the electromagnet force is produced in it, and here we have also a static magnetic field from the permanent magnet. So these both force produces a deflection force in the coil, and if coil is deflected, the spring is attached to it also deflected, and it is giving reading on the scale. So the spring then produce the controlling torque and it oppose further deflection and bringing to it at rest position. This help in the balancing the pointer. Here the deflection force is F equal to BILN. Here the B is the flux density in the air gap, I is the current which we supply to the circuit, and L is the length of coil, and N is the number of turns in the coil. So we know that the torque is proportional to the force into displacement. Here R is the distance between the two center of coil. So if we calculate the torque for this, we can calculate F into R. And if we put the value of F in this equation, we can find that it is FIBILN into R Newton meter. And we know that deflecting torque is proportional to the current, because here all terms are constant. So we can say that here T is proportional to the I, means current. And we know that the controlling torque is proportional to the deflection, means how much deflection is there, it is depends upon the controlling torque. Okay, and it is also depend on the current which we supply, because by this and this equation we can say that I is proportional to the theta. So how much deflection is there, it is depend upon the current is flowing in it. So the pointer deflection is depend upon the current. This is the working principle of the permanent magnet moving coil. Some advantages of the permanent magnet moving coil. Permanent magnet moving coil have high accuracy instrument, and here the torque to weight ratio is high. It means the torque is produced, it is produced the high torque, and weight of this instrument is very less compared to the torque, and it can be modified as a meter or voltmeter with suitable resistance. And here is no hysteresis loss are produced in it. Disadvantage of the permanent magnet moving coil is this instrument is only used on DC supply. It is not used for both AC and DC. It is used only for DC. And it is costly compared to the moving coil. And here the magnetism of the permanent magnet is lost, then air is produced in this instrument. So these are the advantages of the permanent magnet moving coil. Thank you.